Jeanette Miller is from Jeffrey Miller Solicitors and President of the Association of Motor Offence Lawyers. Morning to you, Jeanette.
Morning, Laura.
Now, isn't it the case that in the UK, a fixed penalty comes with a maximum fine of £60, but when the case is referred to a court, there's a maximum of £1,000 unless the offence happens on a motorway where you can be fined up to £2,500?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, Keith was correct in some respects because your income does come into that calculation when it goes to court, but there is a cap on that, so you're right, £1,000 if it's speeding on a non-motorway, and then a maximum of £2,500 if it was on a motorway.
Right, okay. I was a little bit confused, now I'm even more confused, but you've kind of set us straight. So if I'm a rock star and I'm getting £1 million a night,
yeah,
right, and I get done for doing 130 on the motorway,
mm-hmm.
What kind of fine am I looking at then? I'm rich, I'm outrageous, I don't even know if I'm going to turn up to court. That's your job, that's what I'm paying you for, Jeanette. You get down there, I haven't got time, I'm on tour. We're playing Cincinnati on Thursday night. What happens?
Well, the maximum fine, if the offence the rock star is being prosecuted for is speeding, would be £2,500 in that circumstance. So it doesn't matter that this chap or lady is earning significantly more than that. That's the maximum the law allows the magistrates to impose in terms of a fine.
So when is your income taken into account?
Well, it's taken into account when deciding the level of the fine, but it is capped to that maximum. So if you're on, I don't know, £30,000 a year, then the court would take into account what your weekly earnings are and what your outgoings are in deciding whether to fine you the maximum or less than that. And again, it depends on the level of the speed that has been allegedly committed. So if it's a relatively low-level speeding offence, then you can expect probably around 50% of a weekly net earnings amount rather than anything really near the top. But again, it depends on your income.
Where do you see this going, Jeanette? Because in Germany, you can be fined up to £10 million. Last year, a Swedish millionaire mm-hmm. who was doing 180 mile an hour in his new Merc on a Swiss highway was fined nearly £1 million. Do you see the rest of Britain catching, or all of Britain catching up with our friends in Europe and in the United States?
I think it's highly unlikely. There's a proposal at the moment to revisit the amounts of fixed penalties, which is different to the kind of income related fines. But the consultation that has been proposed at the moment is to increase the fixed penalty from £60 to £90, so a 50% increase in line with inflation. And there's been a bit of outrage towards that. So I think if they start to introduce anything along the lines of the Swiss calculation, there would be utter outrage. Although I can see the sense in it in some respects. It's very rare for a client to come to my firm and for the primary concern to be the level of the fine that they're going to receive. It's far more of a concern for them to avoid penalty points or to minimise the penalty points or a disqualification.
But in a recession, a great cash cow for the government. If you got, you know, you only had to get a couple of rock stars a week and we could sort the recession out.
Yeah, absolutely. I think if there were more innovative and creative ways of penalising people, then yeah, there could be more money made. But at the moment, it's a very simple way of collecting fines and raising money.
All right. Okay. Thank you very much, Jeanette, for joining us on the programme today.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you. That's Jeanette Miller. She's president of the Association of Motor Offence Lawyers.